So welcome back to another video here on the channel, and today I am starting the Chucky reviews back on the channel, and I'm starting the Chucky videos back on the channel. So today the first one I'm going to be starting with is obviously the one I wanted to start with first, and that is Child's Play 2019, the remake by MGM Orion Pictures. This movie is amazing and surprised me. This movie surprised me and it was really good. Start to finish, I enjoyed it. Now, before I continue, I want to say you can be a fan of the original as I am, and you can be a fan of this one as I am. You can be a fan of both. There's nothing wrong with that. I gotta make that clear, because some people get upset if you're a fan of the original or the remake. You could be a fan of both. I promise you, it's okay. You know, before I get into the premise and everything, what I can say, this is one of my favorite horror remakes of all time. It does something that a lot of remakes do not do. This gives you a fresh story. This has a fresh story. It has a fresh story, but not only do you get a fresh story, you get fresh characters that we already know. I think that's kind of cool, you know. We got the characters we know and love. We got Carrot, we got Andy, we got Mike Norris, but they're different. They're different, and we got different characters in there as well, like Mike Norris's mom, you know. So I like that spice that they, you know, put in there that, oh, here's the characters that you love, but we're going to make them, you know, different, but in a different way that you're going to actually like. And I love that. I thought the chemistry between Karen and Andy was real. I believed it. And I think the, I think the woman that played Karen, I forgot her name, she did a very good job in the role. And again, her role was believable. Andy, the boy who played him, the boy who played Andy, he did a really good job in the role. And I liked him in the role. You know, this movie really surprised me with the emotions and in the rounds that it took. I knew this movie was going to be good, but what I mean it surprised me was it surprised me in a way how emotional it is, and you know, and the direction that it took. And I love Child's Play. This is my favorite remake. And one of my favorite Chucky movies, I will say it right now, this one and Bride and Part 2 are my favorite ones of all time. Number one, why is this my favorite one? Because this was the first Chucky movie I got to see on theaters. I've talked about this before. I got to see this. They had a special screening on my 19th birthday last year. They had a special screening of this movie at my theater on the 20th. This came out on the 21st. I got to see it on the 20th. Got to see it on my birthday. I remember seeing this on my birthday and being so happy I got to see this in the theaters. Got to see it on my birthday. That's a feeling that that's a feeling that's always going to stick with me. As a horror fan, you know, as a Chucky fan, that's a feeling that's always going to stick with me. You know, got to see my first Chucky movie in the theaters. Got to experience it with horror fans. Got to experience it with Chucky fans. That's amazing to me. You know, I love this movie. Again, the whole atmosphere, the cinematography, the way it's directed, the acting's really good. And I like Mike Norris. I hear people complaining about Mike Norris. Come on. I like Mike Norris in this. Again, I say this again. When you do a remake, in my opinion, everything needs to be ground zero. You really got to start from scratch. This is what this remake does. It takes everything we know about Child's Play, the original, and really just scrape it down and really start from ground zero. And I think that's smart. You know, again, the atmosphere, and again, the emotion, like I said, the emotion and the surprise to me. I never thought in my 19 years of existence, I never thought I would say this, there's scenes where I feel for Chucky. I feel bad for Chucky. Like I just want to save him. You know what I mean? Like, there's actual scenes like that, you know? So, yeah. You know, the kills are really good in this. The gore, the practical effects, the animatronics for Chucky is probably the best in this. I'd say probably since Bride of Chucky, I will say. But now the look of Chucky. Now here's where it gets controversial. The look of Chucky. I don't mind the look of Chucky. It's a look that's actually growing on me. I say it right now. I remember when I first saw this in the theaters and I saw his look, you know, on the big screen. I was like, I like it, you know. But, you know, as I got a few more watches, as I saw it in theaters, and then that time that I rented it on digital, and now owning it on Blu-ray, this is probably my 7th or 10th watch, because like I said, this is probably my 10th watch, and watching, I was like, you know, I actually dig this look. Again, it's not the best look, but it's very good, and it's very close to the original, in my opinion. And no one talks about this. I like how blue that the eyes get. And I love that the eyes glow red when he's evil. I love that. I really do love that. It's unique. It's different. And I think Chucky looks his best in this at the end of the movie. Like when he's got his full red eyes on. His hair is messy. Like that's the Chucky that we know. Mark Hamill. Mark Hamill did a phenomenal job in the role. To me, you can't compare what Brad and Mark did in the role. You can't compare those two. You can't, because they're very different. And these, you know, they're two very different styles of Chucky, in my opinion. You know, I think Mark Hamill just, you know, my opinion, Mark Hamill did just as good as Brad did. You know, Mark Hamill went in there and did his own take on Chucky. He didn't try to mimic Brad. He didn't, you know what I mean? It didn't seem forced or anything. It was just, let me go in there and do me. That's what Mark did. He went in there and did him. Mark Hamill is a really good voice actor. You guys should know this. He voiced the Joker in the animated series. And in the Arkham games. The Asylum in the City and Arkham Knight. Mark Hamill, I thought he did a very good job in the role. He was something different, and I enjoyed it. Again, the look of Chucky, I don't mind the look. It's probably my fourth or third favorite look. I'm not going to lie, it's probably my fourth or third favorite Chucky look. I will say that right now for the sole purpose of it's different, it's unique. I love the red eyes. I love how blue that the eyes are. No one talks about that, you know. We really haven't had Chucky's eyes, like, really blue since Child's Play 2. You know what I mean? And even the first one, really. I love when Chucky's eyes are really blue. That just pops to me. I love that. Some of my favorite scenes is the Zed Mart. Again, I love this movie, and it's perfect to me, but I wish the Zed Mart massacre. I wish that one scene was just extended. Man, I love that scene. The teddy bears. If you've seen this movie, you know what I'm talking about. Like the killer teddy bears. Oh my god. The killer teddy bears. I thought they looked more creepier than Chucky did in this. If they made a sequel to this, just create a Chucky army. You know what I mean? Like actually create a Chucky army. And just have like one of the teddy bears as the leader. I want that. I really want a sequel to this, and I don't know if we're going to get it. I think if I was Orion Pictures, I would have announced the sequel to this last October. That's my opinion, considering the fact this made a pretty good amount at the box office. And there's a fandom behind it. So to me, if something made a reasonable amount at the box office and there's fandom behind it, then yeah, I would make a sequel. You know, my opinion... I would have announced, You know, but you know, and you know, I thought about this before, and you know, it's crazy to think. Maybe we're going to get a sequel to this, but it's not going to get announced until next year. And I say that because if, you know, if we got a sequel to this last year, they would have had to film it this year. And you know what's going on right now with the whole virus and everything. A lot of movies and TV shows are halting production. They're halting shooting. So if they was making a sequel to this, and let's say they were, you know, they started shooting, let's say in January or this month, they would have had, you know, they would have to halt it, stop it, or just delay it indefinitely. So I'm, you know, I feel like, you know, that's a blessing, you know, in some ways. Yes, I want a sequel to this, but as you think about it, if they would be shooting it now to get it out next year, yeah, it will probably get delayed, and I don't want it to get delayed. Yeah, you know, we might not see a sequel to, you know, to this probably until 2022 or 2023, but I don't mind, you know, because again, I would say this right now, if it was shooting now, the whole coronavirus would most definitely shut down production to a sequel to this. So things happen for a reason, and maybe that's why, you know what I mean? So it is what it is, but I hope a sequel gets announced soon. At least they can announce a sequel to this. You know what I mean? There was actually a rumor. I say a rumor because it turned out to be fake. I forgot what movie website posted it. But they post fake news and real news. It's odd. But they was saying there was going to be a sequel to this, and Tiffany was going to be in it. I never reported on it because I watched 3C Films video on it, and I watched more people's videos on it, and come to find out it was fake, and I'm like, I'm not doing that. So there was fake sequel news, and I didn't report on it because it was fake. I love this movie. Andy's friends in this, Pug, I liked him. People complain about his character. I like his character. It's different, you know what I mean? You just can't have the same characters that we know in this movie with him being different. You gotta have some new characters in there. And I like the new characters. I like what they do with Karen. I like what they do with Andy. And I have a lot of favorite scenes in this movie. But one of my favorite scenes and one of my fondest memories is Andy's stepdad getting his kill. I still cheer when I see this scene. Now, obviously, you most likely seen this movie, so I'm going to spoil it. Andy's stepdad has a whole nother family. I remember sitting in the theater last June. I remember sitting in the theater with all these people, and everybody, me and everybody in the theater, was cheering for Andy's stepdad to get his. Man, I love that, because Andy's stepdad was a douche. Like, he was really a douchebag, you know, to Andy, you know, to Karen. He really was. And to find out he had a whole another family and all this, it was just, yes, Chucky, get him. I would never forget that. Everybody in the chair, everybody in the theater, you know, cheering for Chucky to kill this guy. One of my fondest memories. I have so many memories with this. I love this movie, like I said. This whole franchise. I know this is not connected to the original, but I'm just saying, as a whole, this franchise, there's just so many memories for me. There's just so many memories for me with this franchise. What else can I say about this movie? To me, this is a classic. This deserves to be on the spot with the original. Deserves to be on the spot with Bride of Chucky. Deserves to be on the spot with Child's Play 2. Deserves to be on the spot with Curse of Chucky. This deserves that spot. The animatronics are good. The story is actually fresh and unique. The ending to this. Love the ending. Where, like, the worker is putting the Buddy the Chucky doll on the shelf and his eyes turn red. Hinting that there's possibly a Chucky army. Because you've seen the Zed Massacre, you know what I mean. Again, love the story, says viciously fun and clever. That's a good description. It's fun, it's clever, it's fresh, it's unique, it's different, and it's bold. The animatronics are really good. I can do a whole video of why I love this movie. Again, I say this again, you can be a fan of the original and this one. There's nothing wrong with that. You know, I remember when this was announced, people giving it such a hard time, and I was just giving it the benefit of the doubt left and right. And some people, you know, hated on me, you know, for giving this film the benefit of the doubt. But man, I love this movie. I'm dead serious. I may actually watch this again tonight. I may actually watch this again tonight. For real, I'm not even lying. Some of my favorite scenes, the Zed Massacre, the scene where Andy's stepdad finally gets his, the scene where they recreate the car scene, the scene where that weird apartment maintenance man finally gets his, you know, what else are my some? I have a lot of favorite scenes, but those are some of my favorite scenes. If I had to pick one of my favorite scenes out of all of them, it would most certainly be the Zed Massacre. The Zed Massacre, one of my favorite scenes in the entire movie. You know, all the toys coming to life. You know, I love that. And, you know, again, I understand why they... And not a lot of people understand, but I understand. I understand why they decided to go with a AI robot, because it goes with our time. You know, we all have appliances that have a mic in them. We all have some type of Alexa or something in our home that's AI. Most of us have something in our homes that is AI. So I thought that was kind of cool that they did take an AI approach, and it just made the story fresher. Fun fact, you know, the original Child's Play was based around its time as well. The original Child's Play was based around its time, the Cabbage Patch Dolls and all that. So it made sense for the original to do it, so it made sense for the remake to be around our times. So my final thoughts on Child's Play, 2019, this is a classic. This is a classic. This is a must watch. This is a must watch. Love the story, love the kills, love the characters. I love what they do with the old characters. To me, a very original. This is a remake where you can actually say it's original in what it does. And I love it. 10 out of 10 for me. Most definitely, most certainly a 10 out of 10. Like I said, I may watch this again tonight. That's how much I love it. So it's a 10 out of 10 for me. 10 out of 10. Love this movie. I was saying if it had a commentary. Actually, yeah, it does have a commentary. So yeah, probably when I watch this again tonight, I'll probably watch the probably watch it with the commentary, because like the commentary sometimes like gives you little facts and stuff. So I think it's pretty cool. So gonna be watching the commentary on this, because it does have a commentary. Yeah. Again. Love the cinematography, love the kills, love the look of Chucky. Not the best look of Chucky, but I actually dig it. I actually dig the look, especially when his eyes turn red. I think it's pretty sick. I think it's pretty pretty cool. Again, love the look of Chucky. I think this is original. I could talk about this movie all day. Another one of my favorite scenes is the chess scene where Chucky, Buddy, and Andy are playing chess, and like the cat attacks Chucky. Just shows that, you know, there's something, you know, with Buddy, you know. So, love this movie start to finish. 10 out of 10 for me. Love this movie. Let me know in the comments below. Have you seen Child's Play 2019? Let me know what you think of this movie in the comments below. If you have a opinion about this movie, let me know. I love to hear people's opinions about this movie. So let me know your opinion in the comments below. Smash the like button. Please subscribe. Hit the notification bell. Make sure you subscribe. Hit the notification bell. Make sure you share the channel. Share the video. And until next time.